What is the turbine's specific work and the temperature at the exit of the turbine of the following Brayton cycle? Air enters the compressor at 100 kilopascals and 298 Kelvin. The pressure leaving the compressor is 1 megapascals, and the maximum temperature of the cycle is 1,240 Kelvin. The isentropic efficiency is 80 for the compressor and 85 for the turbine. As usual, pause here and try solving this yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the Brayton cycle main lecture, and it uses concepts from the isentropic efficiency main lecture too, so make sure you've studied those two lectures before attempting to solve this problem. The links to those 11 and 8 minute lectures respectively, and all the other lectures of the Thermo course are found in the description below. You've probably noticed already that this is the same Brayton cycle setup we used for the first example. The difference is that this time we're interested in the values for the turbine. Make sure you've watched the first example first. Remember that in the real cycle, the real state 2 is just to the right of 2S, just as 4 is to the right of 4S. The specific work that the turbine can produce, which is what we're looking for, will be the specific enthalpy at the inlet minus the specific enthalpy at the exit, meaning H3 minus H4. And since the efficiency of the turbine is defined as the real work that we're trying to find over the theoretical ideal work H3 minus H4S, the work we're looking for is the given efficiency of the turbine times H3 minus H4S. H3 we can find from the property tables for air at a given temperature 3, and H4S will be the corresponding specific enthalpy value for the temperature at 4 for an isentropic process from 3 to 4. Just like with the previous example, we have two options here to find state 4S. And since we use the pressure values and relative pressures method for example 1, we can use the entropy change expression for this case and say it should be 0 for the isentropic case. We're looking for T4S. T4S will be the temperature that corresponds for the reference entropy at 4S. Therefore, we want to solve for the reference entropy of T4S here. We'll need the reference entropy at T3, which we can get from the table, the gas constant for air, and the ratio between P4 and P3, which is the same as P1 and P2. We substitute the values to find reference S for T4S, and we interpolate to go from that reference entropy value to T4S. Notice that since we were looking for the temperature to find the enthalpy, we didn't really need to find T4S. What we want is the corresponding H value for state 4S, and its reference entropy already fully defines its state. This means that we could just interpolate from S to H directly, without finding T4S first. Regardless, with interpolation, we find H4S. We substitute all of these values to find the work of the turbine. Now, for the temperature at the exit of the turbine, which is 4, not 4S, we can find the corresponding temperature for H4 if we first find H4. And since the real work of the turbine we just found is H3 minus H4, and we have H3, we solve for H4 and with that value, find the temperature that corresponds to it by interpolating. If you want to check out other examples in the ideal and non-ideal Brayton cycles topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to other lectures of the Thermo course, as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!